Saxton is not Danish, by the way. He's Norwegian.
Oops.
Oops.
I had to confirm with my... my brain had to process that real quick. Is that correct? Can we get some smiley faces in chat if that's correct? It looks like Rulldar approves. That's a good smiley. Okay. Everything's good. Thank you, chat. And thank you, Rulldar. It's a very nice smiley. Look at... That's a very good smiley. That kind of looks like one of my emotes. It's still wrong?
Serious? Or the overlay? The overlay is.
Ah, fuck. Whatever. I'll fix it while the map goes.
You're Danish now. Any Danes out there rooting for a Saxon? Fake Dane.
Wait, what? Hold on. A race from Norway. My bad.
That's what I was telling you.
Wait, wasn't it correct before and then I switched it to the wrong thing? Wait, what am I doing? Is everything okay? Am I okay?
You have a Danish flag up there.
Oh, I just realized what I did.
They're both Norwegians.
Are they?
Yeah.
Oh. Okay. All right. Sorry, my brain is losing power. That alien invasion earlier kind of shook me. Yeah, it shook me.
You used all of your energy.
All right, they're both Norwegian. You never would have seen it coming, but a Norwegian battle. Battle of the best Norwegian players in the world, I believe, right now.
Yeah, Saxton with the upset on Sinsa.
And Rulldar took down... Look. So much has happened.
Down Mako.
Oh, yeah. I think I had Saxton's flag wrong on the previous map as well, so apologies to Saxton for that.
Saxton gonna WR? Yeah?
He honestly should just finish a run.
I don't know, WR or nothing.
It is worth noting that Rulldar, again, he has 100% map completion. He is literally the only person in the world with 100% map completion on KSF 66 tick. So pretty showing much any map you throw at him is gonna be at least okay. Like, he's played it before, so yeah.
Putting up a time, I don't think it's respectable. He kind of failed the end.
He's got one though, and
he's got one.
It does matter a lot. We've seen it kind of come into play a few times in previous matches. Just getting a time on the board means a lot.
He's definitely not out of this, because he's got rank 11 on the map.
I'm really curious. I mean, I don't want to get ahead of myself, but I do think this is, like, heavily favoring Saxton. But I also think the next map is going to be interesting to see Saxton play Ambient. Ambient is a map where you're strafing and going all over the place constantly, and he has a 3-foot 360. So, maps like this where it's very smooth and slow, he excels at, but
yeah.
I'm not sure about like the crazy strafe maps. It'll be interesting to see him play. But right now he's losing this map, so if he loses this map, Ambient might be potentially devastating for Saxton. And if you're a TF2 player, I know a few TF2 people are watching right now, Saxton is the TF2 rep, the lone rep from TF2, Red Sea, has been eliminated. So Saxton, the last TF2 surfer alive. I mean, he doesn't surf in TF2 anymore, but you know what I mean. His roots.
Back to his roots. Saxton,
back to his roots.
Does not have a PR on Ambient, on Source. I'm sure he's beaten it on TF2.
Maybe. I can't say that's... Like, we were talking about rare maps. That's definitely a rare map.
Maybe, yeah, maybe he's just never played it. It's not on TF2. Okay, if Zombie's right, then Saxton might get rolled.
We'll see. It is a... Yeah, I think... We'll see. You guys will see. I'm excited for the people that haven't seen the map, because it is pretty wild. But for now, the pressure is still on Saxton, because Rulldar has completed the map twice, and Saxton has not beaten the map once. I want to say Roldar's runs are not that great.
Overlay still says round two. It is still round two.
Yep. Thank you.
Thank
I
you.
Appreciate you guys trying to help, though, because a lot of the time the chat has been helpful, but yeah. It's round one, round two, semifinals, grand finals, and bronze match. Those are the separate rounds on the challenge.
Are there any good Gmod surfers in this tournament? I don't think so.
Yeah, there are a few good Gmod surfers that are like highly ranked overall, but I don't think any of them are in the tournament right now. The only one I can think of is the Shockster.
Priest.
He came from Gmod. He's very good at stage records and bonus records. This looks like a good run. Like, he just needs to finish it. Like, he can kind of moon the end if he wants.
Oh, yeah, this will be... I think this will be pretty hard to beat for Roldar. This is kind of blowing his PR out of the water.
Oh, he screwed up, but I still think it's fast enough.
I don't know.
He lost much speed. He's not even a finish. Oh, God. This is where the nerves set in. There's less than 5 minutes remaining. We need some, like... What's a good spam for Saxton?
I don't know.
His roots are
TF2.
His name is literally a TF2 character, Saxton Hale. So,
is that where he got it from?
I'm assuming Saxton Hale is like a TF2 lore character.
I've never played TF2, so
he's like this big, I want to say Australian guy that just runs around and he's like a superhero kind of. It's weird.
Fitting.
Yep. Superhero Saxton.
Spam the Sax to help Saxton.
That's pretty good.
Spam that Saxton, boys.
He needs it. Because like we said, the next map is... It could be, like, devastating for him. Like, he might not have any chance. So he needs to win this map. Roldar is winning right now with... I want to say not that great of a time. At least for what Saxton can put up on this map.
Definitely. So, he just needs to finish the run.
As long as he doesn't choke. Like, he really doesn't need to... Like, at this point on the map, checkpoint 3, he can play it way more conservatively, I feel.
Very... Yeah, this is a great run.
And it looks like he is playing it more conservatively. He could have cut that way closer.
Roldar
same with this.
Improve, but it's not going to be enough if he finishes this run. Oh my god.
He did
the same thing.
He should just moon it.
He's faster, though.
He's still faster. Oh my god. All right, so the door is wide open for Roldar right now. If Saxton completes again, it's definitely going to be faster, but... I think we gotta watch Roldar.
It's doable. It's within his range. He's got a PR that's better than that.
Mm-hmm. But you can tell, like you can see in Saxton's eyes that was not satisfactory. Like he lost like a full second from that.
Yeah.
Blunder at the end. And in a map like this, a second is a huge amount of time. Like, if he finished that run without failing that end bit, there would have been almost no chance of Roldar beating it. Let's see if he actually makes it work here. This ramp right here has been the death of him. All right, he boards it.
Oh
my god. Let's see. Roldar is ahead of the world record at CP1.
He's flexing on him right now.
Roldar still needs to beat the time, though, but
this is solid,
he's on
though.
Pace. Like, we haven't really seen Roldar's runs this... Oh, okay. I'm going to spec Saxton again, because if he gets the run that he wants, there's no way Roldar can do it, right?
Probably not. It would take a miracle.
I'm thinking like probably around 0.5 world record, 0.5 seconds away from world record. Right now he's 0.21.
It's a bit of a moon.
The time that he set is a second, almost a second and a half, so.
He went really low there. Yep.
Alright, both of them are at the beginning of the start zone. We're on rulldar right now. If rulldar can win this,
huge.
It's very big.
Huge.
He might automatically go into this the semifinals.
It could take him right there.
10 seconds. Rulldar. Last run here.
Spam what do you guys spam for rulldar? Come on.
Maybe some cars?
Spam the car for rulldar. Come on.
There's a lot of good car emojis.
Spam the chocolate bar. Do whatever you need to do.
Yeah, do what you gotta do. You guys survived the alien invasion. I have full faith in you. And he's done. So Saxton does what he needs to do. For posterity, we're gonna just watch him finish this run. Actually, no, there's no way he started this run in time. But yeah, Saxton.
Switch it?
Yeah, give it the switch. Saxton wins. Map one, round two. This best of three here. All right, so we've been talking about this map. Let me know if I need the gamma overlay. It's kind of a weird start zone.
This is
it's like dead zombies.
Was this what happened earlier?
Is it? It might have been
a ritual.
Oh no, I think that's part of the ritual that happened earlier. I'm sorry, guys. So Red Sea's not the only person that didn't survive it.
Monkus.
Oh man, that's definitely a Monkus.
Get a hide spec.
All right, well, yeah, I think I'm gonna put the gamma thing on, and this map seems pretty dark. Yeah, that looks a lot better. So we're gonna
burn their eyes.
Burn your eyes. All right, well, despite rulldar being like behind. This looks like a heavily favored matchup for rulldar. If you don't have experience on this map, it's going to just be hard to complete.
It doesn't look like Saxon's ever played this on source. He's had to have played it somewhere else, though. His PR info says he's never played it.
He's never played it. Wow.
I mean, he looks like he knows what he's doing, though.
Oh, yeah. So basically, this map, you get a crazy boost at the start. A lot of, like, short ramps across a narrow area with these holes that you can head hit off of, which means you are literally hitting your head. And it pushes you down quicker, as you can see. So you basically want to hit the perfect angle on those small openings every single time. Which actually makes a significant difference on this map. If you miss those head hits, it's not that the head hit gives you speed, it's that you lose a lot of time if you miss it, because you kind of go up and swirl around. Just spec rule on this, okay? We'll listen to Saxton. This is Roldar's map, after all. Oops. In fact, Silver Thing, who was casting earlier, I believe... Does he still have the world record on this map?
Yeah.
I think he does. I think this world record on this map is actually considered to be, again, one of the better ones. There's a lot of maps that kind of fall into that category. But this map and Tronic are kind of the two maps in the map pool that are considered to be very optimized runs. And not easy maps at all to even
complete. Roller failed the end. Could have got some pressure off him.
Oh, yeah. I think what Saxton is probably hoping for in this situation is just that rulldar can't beat the map and Saxton can get a completion. And honestly, yeah. You never know. This map is hard. It's either a harder tier 4 or a tier 5 map. So, for those that don't know, again, we're going to reiterate this a lot. The higher the tier, the harder the map, and there's 6 tiers. So,
what tier do you think it is?
I would say tier 5.
Tier 4.
Alright, it's definitely a harder tier 4. It's definitely a harder tier 4, I would say. And I think the only reason it's tier 4 is just because the map is extremely short. And Rulldar looks like he knows what he's doing. Like, he is zooming. It's very hard to retain your speed throughout this map. You can beat it going slow, absolutely, but going fast like Rulldar is right now is very difficult. And if he gets this completion, it might be over.
That's all he needs.
29 second map.
As of right now.
Yep. He's got the completion. I'm gonna head over to Saxton here and see if he can do it.
He's no slouch. He's getting somewhere.
Yeah, absolutely. We saw him and Sinza play Placid. Both of them didn't have a PR in the map, I think. And they both got top 20 times. I think that was Placid.
Yeah.
But getting a top 20 time on a KSF server in 20 minutes having not played the map is, you know, pretty good. Pretty good. There's a lot of people that have played on these servers over the years. But yeah, if Saxton can somehow beat Rulldar's time of 29 seconds, he will eliminate Rulldar. We'll see, we'll see. The next map in this best of three is Resource. That's an interesting map.
Yeah.
I don't know who it would really favor. I think it's kind of like middle ground for both of them.
Yeah, I'm not a big fan of that map. Not sure why. I think it's just really compact.
Yeah. I mean, I haven't played it in a long time, but I really don't know who the map would really favor. I think it's kind of like a very good middle ground for both of these players. So if things go according to plan and Rulldar hangs on for this map, which in all honesty, I have the utmost faith in Saxton, but this map is just so tricky. But yeah, and if things go according to plan, we're going to be going to a third map, a map in which doesn't really have a strong favorite, in my opinion. You can check the PRs on them if you want, but
I'll do that.
I'm curious if Saxton has played it before. Rulldar improves his time with 5 minutes left to go. So 28 seconds is the time to beat now for Saxton.
Saxton's only beaten stage 1 and 2.
Okay. Yeah, we'll see, we'll see.
But Roldar's time is ranked 250.
Oh. Alright, so Rulldar may have just played it for a completion, that's it. And that might not even account for anything, honestly. Other than, like, a little bit of familiarity with the stages. For now, we're gonna watch this run down. Rulldar improving again. I want to see Nim versus Rulldar on this map. Or yeah, or like two players that are comfortable on this map.
Come on, Saxton.
Doing all right. So is that a skip? Or do you want to just, like, touch the top of the ramp? Because it looks like he's trying to skip that ramp.
You do skip the ramp.
Okay.
He just doesn't have quite enough speed on it.
There's really no other maps like this where you just get, like, a crazy boost at the start in, like, a kind of confined space. Like, I know Surf Fast you get a crazy boost at the start, but it's a very open map. I can't think of any other maps that are like this.
Yeah.
Yeah, time's a ticking for Saxton here. 3 minutes left. He told me at the start of the round, he told me to spec Rulldar only, so we'll see if Rulldar can keep improving his time. You gotta save your cheers for the tiebreaker, y'all. Unless you truly believe in Saxton. The real stands, the real fans of Saxton are gonna still cheer him on this map. He's got 3 minutes. Less than that, I actually started the timer a tiny bit late.
Bam that sax, boys.
Get that sax.
He's got a chance.
He's got a chance. Like, how much speed do you think the chat gives the players? Like, what's the range?
It's got to be, you know, like 50% of it.
You guys are 50% of the players. You have that much power. I don't know if Twitch has been able to provide that much power for any other stream, so you guys are enabled. You can do it. Do you believe in Saxton? Spam it, Zach.
Exclamation boost in the chat to give Saxton a boost.
It does work. It's proven. Yeah, this map is so hard to learn. I can't believe multiple players in this tournament are comfortable playing it. Like, I thought this was like... whose map picked... Who do you think put this map in the map pool? Maybe Nim? Maybe?
Yeah. It's gotta be. He's ranked 2.
It's a very smart decision on Rulldar. It seems like a lot of the people that have been picking so far this tourney have taken advantage of people that haven't played some of the maps in the map pool. Despite Saxton being a top player in the world, he has a low completion percentage. He just gets like world records on the map that he does play, so that's how he's such a high rank.
He's gonna put in a run here, but it's not enough.
At least he gets it.
Yeah. Some confidence.
Good job, chat. All right, 30 seconds remaining.
Gonna need a few more Saxtons. Saxes in the chat, I mean.
You know, he did get that run in. He's standing completely still. Wait a second, is he channeling the energy? Like, is he gonna get like a mega boost?
God.
Okay.
I commend anyone who beats this map. Time's up.
He's on a run, though.
Looks okay. Oh, wait.
Back.
Maybe. He can get the skip?
Oh, my God. That looks so hard. He couldn't get it. So, as we predicted, that was definitely Rulldar's map. Saxton being able to complete it was very impressive, though. Especially if it was, like, his first time playing the map. That's not an easy one to do. So, we got Nim and draft next, but I almost forgot we have the last map for Rulldar and Saxton. It's Surf Resource. I'm gonna skip that song. It's a little weird. All right. I don't know if we need that gamma filter. Let me know if we need the gamma filter.
Probably not. There's some good lighting on this map, I think.
All right. Rulldar is ready. Came back from an 0-1 deficit. Saxton. Kind of got blown out last map.
Brighter.
We'll see if he can bring it back. Brighter? We'll
Launder,
see.
Launder says brighter.
We'll wait until they start surfing, because this start zone's kind of dark. If you guys still want it brighter later on, let me know. Look at all those bright cubes and stuff floating around.
Who made this map again? This is
I think this is a BG map.
BG map.
I like the aesthetic. It's very cool.
Oh yeah, definitely.
So yeah, winner of this map goes to the semifinals. Loser goes home.
Who do you guys want to win? Spam that saxophone if you want Saxton, and spam that car for Rulldar.
The car versus the saxophone.
I'm seeing a lot of saxophones right now, man. Not a lot of cars.
The TF2 support is strong.
It really
There's
is.
There's a lot of people that surf in TF2. We'll see. We'll see. Can the saxophone blow the car away?
Red Sea came through with a saxophone in there. I saw it.
Okay. Okay.
Cheering on his fellow TF2er.
Rulldar just improved by his PR by 12 minutes. So, pretty solid improvement by Rulldar.
Good job, Rulldar.
Good job, good job. Well done. Well, the shackles are already being applied to Saxton. He definitely is going to need more saxophones.
Definitely.
Like, I don't think he has a PR on this map. Oh, you said he has a... He's beaten the first two stages. Okay. There's four stages, though.
He seems like he knows what he's doing.
He really does. Like, even on maps where... Like, that last map... He generally looked like he knew what he's doing.
Oh, he does. This looks good. I jinxed him.
Also, just to let you guys know, the map picks and bans are done, like, about a half an hour before each match. So that might be why the players are a little bit more familiar, despite their completion. So maybe that's why. Maybe he had, like, 30 seconds or 30 minutes of practice before the map. The match. Pressure's on Saxton. No, Rulldar's got that completion. I want to know, like, I'm sure we can drop some statistics after the tournament ends, but I want to know what, like, the win percentage of the player that completes the map first is.
Yeah.
I want to say it's probably really, really high.
Right. Probably.
But yeah, Saxton on stage. Nope.
Almost.
Rulldar improving his time again. I don't think you or I are very familiar with this map, so it's hard to tell, like, what times are actually good that
yeah,
he's getting.
I'm not really sure.
It is 5 seconds off the world record, but there might be some, like, crazy shortcuts that are just not applicable to a tournament like this.
Yeah. Saxton looks like he's doing all right, though. I mean, just keep up this pace and you should be good.
Oh, yeah. Roldar's 5 seconds behind the world record on his run, and right now in Saxton's run, he's a half second behind.
We'll be able to see right here. Okay.
Wow. Okay. That's definitely an okay, for sure.
Okay.
Okay. He needs the saxophones. This could be the tournament-defining run for him, if he can complete this stage. He's about halfway through right now.
He's about to beat the map for the first time ever.
He literally is.
Oh
my god. I actually think he could have finished with that too.
Yeah.
Let's see where Rulldar is. He's on stage 4, and Rulldar looks like he's going to improve his time once again. Absolutely. Oh wow. Okay. Rulldar very consistent at completing the map, but Saxton kind of gunning it. We mentioned that Truffle earlier said if he was in the tournament, he would gun literally all 10 minutes. He wouldn't play it safe at all. And
that's a bold strategy.
That's what Saxton's doing. He's not really playing it safe at all.
Definitely.
I don't know. I get this feeling that Saxton's going to, like, definitely be able to do it. He has 5 minutes. That's not much time, but he needs one run. We'll see. He needs it. It needs to be roughly 3 seconds faster, or three seconds slower than the world record. As you can see on the HUD right there, for those that might not understand what we're talking about, after each stage, it shows how far away from the world record they are, so you can kind of keep track of that as well. So right now he's on great pace. He's plus 15 away from the world record. And he needs to be around plus 2.5 to beat Rulldar's time.
He's shown he can definitely do it.
Car
or
like, who
saxophone?
Knows?
Who knows?
That's a good one. Who knows? Two.
Which one are you taking here, Kurt? Car or saxophone?
I honestly... I have to say I'm a little biased, but I gotta go with the saxophone, man.
I knew it.
Despite Saxton not having a map completion yet, from what we haven't really watched Rulldar much, but his Saxton's runs look really good. So if he's able to complete it,
that was a good cut.
I think he's gonna beat him, and I think this is it.
Yeah, this should be.
Oh my god!
Wait. Yeah,
that's it. Okay. That's it by a full second. So the pressure has been transferred to Rulldar.
The shackles of Titan. 3 minutes left.
Saxton, if you want Rulldar, you need to spam the car. He might only have 3 minutes. 3 minutes left in this tournament.
He needs all the speed you can give him at this point.
Yeah. You guys gave Saxton some speed, but can you give Rulldar some love? I don't know. It's up to you. You can also give Saxton more love if you want.
We need the car. From what I'm seeing by these checkpoints, he's going to need a few thousand cars.
You think so?
I don't know.
I guess he is on stage two and he's already half second behind.
Yeah.
Maybe a stage one is just not so good. I don't know.
I think it is not so good.
But it is cool to see two different strategies at play right now. Rulldar kind of just went for completions. Saxton went for the God run. Is it the God run? I guess we find out if he wins the round. He did get it. He did get the run he was going for.
We'll see in a second when he finishes the stage. Okay, they're about even, I think. Rulldar's looking pretty composed right now.
Absolutely. Like, this no jitters at all. And his strafes are real smooth.
Oh, this is a really good stage, I believe.
Okay.
Doable.
It's definitely doable. He needs to be under 1 minute 14 seconds 26 hundredths
wow.
of a second.
Okay, that was a really good cut. Oh.
Okay. This may very well be his last run. There's a minute and a half left.
We're going to need all the cars that you can give us. Help Rulldar out.
Vroom, vroom.
Vroom, vroom.
Don't waste no gas. Just give him your car, dude. Give him your car. He needs it.
He's got to gun it.
Give him the Nox.
Here he goes. Oh, my
okay.
God.
Okay. He still has time. 40 seconds.
He's AFK.
Okay, I just wanted to tell him to keep going just in case he didn't know that he can go after the timer expires. Don't want him to give up.
Don't
he
give
has
up,
so many cars in his arsenal right now.
Oh my god, you're a millionaire if you win. You get all the cars.
We're adding the cars to the prize pool. Every car spammed in chat is one more car into the prize pool.
It is.
Is he going to clutch it out? The timer's going
to
expire.
This
run is on pace.
This has to be it. It's a decent cut. Wow, okay.
Oh, no.
He's not holding back.
I don't think that was good. No, it wasn't.
I mean,
but it could be good enough.
He's gonna have to do this stage the best he's ever done it.
It's looking good so far. He kind of mooned there. He's shaking. I don't know. I think he's gonna get the completion, but he's mooning a little too high.
That was an insane board.
He has so much speed.
That was.
He's gonna complete.
Decent. What's it gonna be? Oh, nope.
Wait, it wasn't enough?
Nope.
No. Damn, good showing from both players. Saxton, the TF2 representative, gets in there. Semifinals
Another
for Saxton.
Great series.
Yeah, another great series. You have to win this shit, Kay. His fellow Norwegian buddy. Well played to Rulldar. Very well played to... Oh, man. These have been some good matchups. That was a good map.
Yeah, that was.